To learn Scratch, we've been looking at Scratch 2, but there is a new Scratch 3. So what's that like? Let's compare the new Scratch with Scratch 2. If we compare the new Scratch 3 to the old Scratch, you can see we have the similar blocks. So if we go through the blocks, we can see we have the same blue blocks. In the new version of Scratch, they are a bit bigger and clearer to see, and we can move them over the same. The one thing you notice with the new Scratch is that we can scroll down. So if we go to looks, we can either click on the circle or we can scroll down for the blocks. But again, they're the same blocks. So we can look through them. We still have the say hello for 2 seconds, the same costume blocks, and show and hide. We still have the same. We have sound next. Now it looks like there's less blocks here, but the sound, if we look at the tab, the sound, with the sound we have different things that we can do with that under the tab. And under costume you can see it's also different. So there are slight differences that take a little bit of getting used to. So we go back to the tab, we can look in events. So we'll see that the blocks are again the same. And control next, we can see again we have the same loop blocks, repeat, forever, ifs, wait until. Then sensing, light blue blocks, operators, again the same, variable and data, not quite the same here. We've got my variable, so there's a variable that exists already, so you don't need to create a new one, and we have make a list the same. So the only slight difference here, we have more blocks, and we have my blocks here. And the extension you can see in the corner, the bottom corner, is different. So we'll show you that in a minute. The other major difference, apart from the fact that the blocks are on a different side, and the sprite area is also on the different side, they changed that around, so that takes a bit getting used to, is that normally we have the eye with the sprite, and that gives us the information. To click on the eye, we can see the information. In the new sprite, there isn't an eye, there's just a cross to close it. We could see the information above, so at first that might not be obvious, but if you want to rename the sprite, we can. Above, you can see sprite, and then you can highlight the text and rename that. We have show and hide as well, and we have the same, but instead of using the information with the eye, it's already above there. You can see with the stage and the sprite down the bottom, we have these pictures that if you hover over, you can see we have the same options. I choose the sprite, paint. Got a surprise one there, and an upload sprite. And just to look at the backdrops, we're going to choose a backdrop. Yeah, we can look at the backdrops. We have the menu at the top as well, and we can click top left is back. And the sprite, if we look at the sprite, you could, if you put the mouse over, you hover the mouse over the sprite, you can see the other costumes. So you can see the person walking, or someone like the bat flying. So these are the other costumes. So if you leave your mouse over the picture, over the sprite, you can see the different costumes. If there's only one costume, obviously it doesn't change. But for example, you can see the butterfly looks like it's flying. So we can have a look at the different ones and move the cursor over, and we can see, for example, like the cat walking. Okay, let's see what it's like using the new Scratch 3. So it's slightly different, especially with the blocks to the left and moving up and down. But let's see if we can make a program. So we're going to start off by looking at asking for some text, and then translating it, and then using the new extension and then saying what the translation is. So we're going to ask and then wait in sensing, and then we're going to use this my variable that's already there, set the variable. So we're going to use my variable in a loop so we can use different translations. So we've got set my variable to answer and start with the green flag. So we're going to get some text and the answer is going to go into my variable. Now we need, we're going to say that. So we're going to repeat what the person asks. Let's check to see if that works. So let's start it. What would you like to translate? We're going to say hello. What should we say? Hello to all, or hello everyone. Hello my friends. So here it, the cat says the text that's been entered. So we know what's going to be translated. So let's have a look at these extensions. We can use these down the bottom. There's a link to add. And you can see there's different ones here. And we're going to use the translate. So we're going to click on that. And then it just adds the blocks for us. So we've got a translate block. We're going to move that across. And we've got, at the moment, it's got translate hello to check. So we want to say that. And we want to say the my variable instead of hello. So we're going to translate my variable to different languages. We're going to start off with some common, so languages like French. So say whatever the text is to French for 2 seconds. Should we try that? So what would you like to translate? We've got hello. Hello, my friend. My friends. Hello, my friends. And then bonjour and amis. My French not very good, but I believe that's correct. Let's hope so. So we want to translate more languages. So what we can do is we can create a list of languages. So we're going to translate my variable, but we're going to translate it into different languages. Maybe, what should we try? 6 languages. So we're going to use a repeat loop and we're going to add, so we're going to add the translation to languages, and we're going to do that 6 times. So we can just duplicate the block, or duplicate 2 blocks, make it faster. Just 6. So here we can add the 6 blocks, they're all the same. But obviously we're going to change the language. So let's try Chinese, or Dutch, then Chinese. What else should we have? We'll look down quite a few languages. Greek. How about Japanese? Oh, Italian first, and then Japanese. Okay, so we've got all of them in our list. And now we can use a loop to say each one. So we can repeat that, the length of the loop, the length of the list, and then say those translations. So we need to get the length of the list, which we can get from variable. So put that block in, length of languages, and then we're going to say my variable for 2 seconds. So you can look through the blocks if you're not sure of these, and we want to say the item number of the languages. Yeah, so we've got to add a new variable. We're going to call this number. We're going to go number, start off with number as 1, and then we're going to go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So set variable to number to 1. There we go. And then we're going to change number by one in the loop. When you drag them, the blocks, when you're not used to the blocks going up and down, and sometimes it goes up and down, it takes a little while to get used to scratch 3. It's slightly different from scratch 2, as obviously you can see. It takes a little bit of getting used to. So let's try this. Is there anything missing? Right, we want to take out whatever in the languages to begin with, in case that's held over from the last time we ran. And then we're going to try entering some text. Again, hello my friends. So we can try any text and see if it translates. What we found is perhaps the first time you translate it, it takes a lot longer. But once you translate it once you run the program once, it will be quicker on the second time or any time you run it after. So actually we can see this is already running. So we can see there's a Greek, an Italian, Japanese. So let's try to run that again, shall we? So let's run it again. What would you like to translate? We're going to enter again, hello my friends, and we're going to run it. And it says hello my friends. And here, look, we've got the French. So this has run Dutch, Chinese, Greek, Italian, and then the Japanese finally. So that ran a lot quicker then. So that worked. Here's the blocks. If we look at the extensions, we can see music, pen, video sensing, text-to-speech, translate, obviously we've already looked at, and some others. So let's have a look. If we add the music, and let's add text-to-speech. So when we get our answer, we can get our answer again and put it in the text-to-speech system. So if we can find answer in sensing, so now our text-to-speech system should say once the text once we've typed it in. And music, what do we want in music? How about play some notes? So let's play a drum once we've finished. Should we play a drum? What should we close with? We close with a crash cymbal. So let's try that if we run our program. So we can start our program, enter in our text. Hello everyone. So let's see what that does.
Hello everyone.
Ah. So now we can hear it on our text-to-speech system, and we have the translations in French and Chinese and Greek and Italian and Japanese. And there's our symbol to finish off with. Okay, we finished for this video, so thank you for watching. If you feel that you are comfortable with Scratch and you want to move on to a programming language like Python, then you're in luck, because we plan to do a series on how you can use Scratch when you're learning a programming language, and we're going to use Python as the example. So look out for that will be coming soon. Okay, if you haven't already, please subscribe and then you'll know when the series comes out. Okay, bye for now.